buzz surrounding which officers might be in the U.S. Justice Department's line of fire is being felt across the entire metro area. With one guilty plea under his belt, the U.S. attorney appears to be zeroing in on what feds describe as a conspiracy to hide the truth. WDSU News anchor Norman Robinson explains.
While the initial probe of police conduct focused on the so-called Danziger 7, the seven officers who took part in the post-Katrina shooting, this week's guilty plea has broadened the spotlight to include those who investigated the incident. Former NOPD Lieutenant Michael Lohman never drew his weapon. He wasn't there to see the gunfire, but his admitted actions after the fact point to a wide-ranging conspiracy. Former U.S. Attorney Julian Murray says it appears the feds are now honing their sights on the alleged cover-up.
Well, they could charge him with the conspiracy, just like they charge Lohman. That's not likely because he's got the deal. But they charge him with obstruction. They can get 20 years for that. The false statement, you can get 5 years for that, and you can get 20 years on the false filing of the documents. So you look at 45 years just for the cover-up.
Like Lieutenant Lohman, Sergeant Arthur Kaufman was another investigator sent to the scene. His attorneys have said Kaufman received a letter indicating federal prosecutors are studying his role. Though not mentioned directly by name, the Bill of Information against Lohman appears to make reference to Kaufman and two other sergeants who actually took part in the shooting. Robert Jacivius is one of those sergeants, and he, like Kaufman, has been notified that his actions are being studied. To date, Kaufman and Jacivius are the only officers known to receive target letters from the U.S. attorney. Investigators have confiscated files tied to others, such as Sergeant Gerard Duguay, who was also assigned to the Danziger probe. Duguay's attorney now tells WDSU no plea deal has been entered, but he has met with federal prosecutors, and he believes other defendants have also had recent meetings. Meantime, Police Superintendent Warren Riley, for the second time, delivers a terse message for those officers in question.
All I can tell you is that if there are any other officers that are involved in this, they need to go to jail. That's all I can tell you. You know, I have no sympathy for them. Suffer the consequences. Period.
Anchor Norman Robinson reporting. Now, some legal experts say the feds are kicking the probe into high gear because the statute of limitations for the charges runs out in September.